Dear students of 10th class, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The remaining portion of the short story, The Necklace. Her friend did not even open and check the necklace as Mrs. Loisel had expected. Mrs. Loisel was worried about what would happen if her friend came to know about the replacement of the necklace. She could blame her to be a thief. Mrs. Loisel realized how horrible life could become. She knew that they would have to pay the loan that they had taken for the necklace at any cost, so they started to reduce their expenses and some more. They removed the maid from her job, changed their house, and rented rooms on the roof of a building. Now she had to learn the tiring and boring work of the kitchen, like washing dishes and cooking food. She would wash clothes and hang them on the line to dry. She used to go down the street each morning to get water. With the little money she had, she used to dress like ordinary people and go to the grocery shop, the butcher shop, and the fruit shop with a basket to buy the things of daily use. The husband was also in a miserable condition, as he used to work extra time in the evenings and often did copying work at night for a small amount of 5 sous a page. They did this for 10 years and paid back their debt within this period. By this time, Mrs. Loisel had become a hard-working woman of the poor household. She had started looking old, with her hair badly kept, hands red, and she used to speak in a loud voice many times to feel good. When her husband used to go to work, she would sit next to the window and think about the party at the minister's house. She used to feel good about how beautiful and elegant she looked that day. She would imagine about how her life would be if she would not have lost the necklace. She used to think about how unpredictable life could be and how a small step could change a person's life. One day she was relieving herself of the stress of the week and enjoying a walk along the Champs Elysees when she suddenly saw a lady walking with a child. The young, pretty, and attractive lady was Mrs. Forrester. Mrs. Loisel started thinking about whether she could talk to her or not. She decided that as she had given her the necklace back and paid back all the debts, there was no reason for her not to talk to her. Mrs. Loisel went to her and said, "Good morning, Jenny." Mrs. Forrester was confused, as she could not recognize the person, but thought that she was familiar because only her close friends used to call her by that name. She told her that she might be looking. She told her that she might be might have got, sorry, she might have got the wrong person, and that she might be looking for someone else. But Mrs. Loisel introduced herself to her old friend and Forrester was shocked to see her in such a poor and changed look. She then replied that she did not have some hot days. She did have some hot days since they last met. She said that life had been miserable and it was all because of Mrs. Forrester. Then Mrs. Forrester asked how was she responsible for her bad days, to which Matilda replied that she had lost Forrester's necklace. So this Mrs. Forrester replied that it was not possible because she had returned it to her. Matilda replied that she had bought a similar necklace and they had been paying the debt for the last 10 years. She also said that they were not that rich to afford such an expensive necklace. Matilda added that their debt was now over and that she was satisfied with whatever she had. Jenny was surprised and asked Matilda if she bought a diamond necklace just to replace her lost necklace, to which she replied yes. Mrs. Forrester was touched while holding her in her arms. She said that the necklace which she had borrowed from Mrs. Forrester was a fake necklace and that it was not worth more than 500 francs. Thanks.